nigga from Brooklyn, just how he walk. The Brownsville dudes carry gas in they drawers. Come through rocking a Relly, better have it in short. East New Yorkers will stab a millionaire till he bleed riches. Cop work from uptown niggas, fuck Queens bitches, four green killers. Run up in your living room quick. Them boys in Canaan, see you lay your click on a strip. Nobody politics in Bed-Stuy, who cares for that political shit? We're all with dog fuzz, kibbles and bits. Bushwick got beat cops, they acting like they own the streets. That's why we drop them like a verse and lay them on a beat. Celebrate Easter by going to Coney Island with heat. Just to have a slash out and bang it out on the beach. In Crown Heights, they be working them too. Red Hook hoodlums, come around your way and put your turf on the news. Downtown and Pickin' Ave got the fly sneakers. Youngins taking over the trains, cursing over the loudspeakers. Flatbush, they be toting. Leotop smoking since the trains had tokens. Them boys kept it loking. From LG to Albany, we was born to be thorough. Cypress Hills to Kingsboro, we the Kingborough. I'm from Bainbridge, we broke the law for the fun. Them cats in Marcia make you cough up a lung. Wherever you from, represent the hood you live. But keep it that way, don't come across the Brooklyn Bridge.
The mother ghetto where it first unlocked the crook born. My borough led the thoroughbreds, Brooklyn. Y'all outsiders better come right, don't look wrong. My borough led the thoroughbreds, Brooklyn.
Heaven above my hood, them pearly gates is locked. We the reason the cops traded 38s for Glocks. We the reason them cabs ride by and never trust you. We the reason you couldn't rock shines in the tunnel. Niggas be staring and walking looking back. But I rob a nigga blind and ask him what the fuck he looking at. Patrol cars just wanna get central booking packed. Don't get caught in alleys with Brooklyn cats. Face the fact in which you worship. So I pray with my back towards the serpent. Hit the underground and chased all the rappers to the surface. Celebrated Ike after he was murdered. Through tradition we had him cremated. Put his ashes in the Sherman. I wish I could've did magic when they burned him. Cause the depths of this double is fire. Within these matches don't deserve him. Israelites stand on the abs of the urban with a staff giving sermons. Knowledge beneath the rappers of a turban. Security stay harassing and lurking. When a Brooklyn thug walk in the club, bouncers ask us, can they search us? Why you patting by my burners? You acting like you nervous. Make a mistake and get shot by accident on purpose. 718-187, y'all faggots must have heard us. Our area code got the same factors of a murder. Wherever you from, represent the hood you live. But keep it that way, don't come across the Brooklyn Bridge.
The mother ghetto where the first thug walk, the crook born. My borough led the thoroughbreds, Brooklyn. Y'all outsiders better come right, don't look wrong. My borough led the thoroughbreds, Brooklyn.
Help Hip Hop Radio. I get hype when I hear good music. I get hype. That re-up joint I played, I got hype. Papoose set tripping, I got hype. William Young featuring Slim Jackson, Scaluminati, I got hype. Relly Tex, Family Feud, I got hype. Blaze the Rap Bully, Fuck Up the Club, got hype. Frio, Finesse, got hype. Stimulation, the Ghetto God, Thousand Bitches, got hype. Treasure in the Trunk, Headman, got hype. Shams Pacino, Don't Shoot, got hype. Papoose, Mother Ghetto, got hype. I'm just saying, y'all, it feel good to be able to listen to music and play the music, knowing that the brothers are talented. Round of applause for the brothers that are talented. Let's not take away too much going on. 315-320-3457. If you got something to talk about with the new Sean Williams topic, please call in. Please call in. Now, this injustice happens all the time. Now, I was actually locked up with a rapist before. I was at the house when a little girl supposedly, allegedly got raped. And when we went outside to find the guy was long gone. Well, I was in North Carolina facing some time, and I was inside the jail and whatnot. So I'm in the yard, and while I'm in the yard, I see this guy, and I look. I'm like, hold on. Yo, what's your name? And when he told me his name, I took the basketball and smashed it right in the face. Boom! Right then and there. Boom! Started popping on him. His brother was the CEO in there, come to find out. So his brother take me to the hole, put me in the hole. He like, yo, Mike, what you do that for? I'm like, yo, listen, man, I was there that night. I was there the night when he raped that little girl. The brother wound up letting me out the hole. Long story short, right? His prison sentence was 6 months. The girl was 8 years old, and he was in his 30s. So what I'm saying is, and yes, of course, yes, you know what I'm saying? He was Caucasian. You know, not to throw any shade on it, but yeah, he was Caucasian. You know, in the South, it works a little different. And I'm looking at the situation now with Nushawn. I don't condone him messing with no 13-year-old girl. I'm not supporting that one. But I'm also not supporting doing a 16-year bid for consensual sex, and it was statutory. See, rape is rape, point blank, period. But when you misleading somebody and taking advantage of them, it's a whole nother situation. So like I said, he's supposed to be having a book coming out soon. I spoke to the author today. The author is actually writing his book, The Nushawn Williams Story. Got a call on the line, y'all. Got to get the call on the line. Hello, Cole, are you there?
Yeah, what's going on, man?
Everything good, man. The topic today, man, is Nushawn Williams. Do you know who Nushawn Williams is?
Oh, yeah, man. Bad story, bro.
Do you know the story?
Yeah. About them imprisoning him falsely?
Yeah, man. But, you know, he's still locked up right now.
No, I didn't know that, man.
Yeah, he's still locked up right now, and they won't release him because they're saying he's still a threat to society, being that he had so much sex in his life. You know, so they kind of looking at it like he's a sexual predator, even though he doesn't have HIV.
And that's foul, man, because there's so many brothers, especially when they get locked up back in the 80s and 90s, when we didn't have proper tests and like DNA and all that stuff, man. There's so many brothers wrongly accused and wrongly locked up, man. I think that's foul, man.
I think so as well, man. I got a friend who's actually going to write his book. You know, I don't want to say his name yet. Don't want to disclose the information, but he's supposed to be writing the book for him. Did you interested in that?
Yeah.
When he starts the writing of the book or whatever, I'll announce who he is. And I'll definitely keep you updated on this. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, man. Yeah, because, I mean, that kind of even flows into the talk with the, you know, the Bill Cosby and all the other people that's coming out. Don't get me wrong. If something happens to you wrong, you need to stand up and say it. Mm-hmm. But sometimes it gets fishy when people report stuff 20, 30 years later, and you never know what really happens. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of foul, man.
Well, that's going on with Russell Simmons as well right now. You see that?
Right, man. Hey, yeah, man. And then everybody's coming out of the woodworks with these stories, man.
But you know what's crazy about it? See, these are not like regular black people. You know what I'm saying? Like, all right, let's look at Bill Cosby. Bill Cosby was the household father for all of us. He raised us, right? Now, let's look at Russell Simmons. Russell Simmons is the backing behind the whole hip hop movement and the reason why Obama was president. So we're being targeted right now. Non-violent.
Yeah, man. But you know how it is now, especially if you're famous, people do anything to be around you. And then now, 10, 15, 20 years later, now they're saying like, well, I did stuff I didn't want to do, but you did what you did to get in the position that you was in, man. I mean, it goes both ways, but I'm saying, man, people have to know the real story that goes behind these things.
That's right. And they're only going to give us half of the story. They're going to let us know the whole story. My whole thing is, you know, when a woman comes out 2-3 years later and you're a grown woman, I can't side with them and say, well, they were scared about their life and stuff like that. I have to look at it like, you're grown. You understand how to go to the authorities. They know how to do that.
Yeah, we were talking about that on the podcast earlier this morning. I forgot to my friend, man. We were talking about that subject, man, because it's real deep, man. a lot of them will argue with me about it. But I'm saying you're a grown woman or a grown man. You, like with Kevin Spacey, the dude they're accusing was 17 years old. Like, you're a grown man. Nobody influences you to be gay at 17 years old.
That's
right. You know what you feel like doing. Then years later, you're coming out about it because you're ashamed of what happened, man. It put people in iffy positions, man.
Yeah, man. Another one, Marcus Houston, I'm saying, was accused by the B2K member. You remember that?
Right, yeah, man.
So, you know, it's funny, you know what I'm saying, to see these people come out later with these situations, but, you know, it's also a messed up situation, man. You know, just building on that topic today, because we need to bring awareness in our communities about the injustice of the criminal justice system, you know?
How you got to come up with those topics, man. Those are good discussion points, man.
I really appreciate you, brother. I do have people that call in, like, such as yourself, you know what I'm saying, behind the scenes, that, you know what I'm saying, to bring up something, you know, and just tell me, like, yo, this is what you need to talk about. I'll do the research on it and come back with it. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
Yo, I can't hold up the line, though, man.
I like that treasure truck you played, man. I want to see if you can get that 82 and 87, though.
Yeah, man, I try to do that. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? I definitely try to do that tonight. You know what I'm saying? We actually rocking out. We got like 3 minutes left. You know what I'm saying? So I actually got to rock up the show. But if not, man, you know where to go on the mall, man. Definitely get that treasure trunk back on. You heard?
I bet that.
Yo, I appreciate you calling in, brother. You heard?
All right, much love.
Cool. That's what I'm talking about, man. Callers, this is your platform, man. Got another caller calling in right now. You know how that go. Got to give the callers their time to shout it out and whatnot. You know what I mean? Don't hold people like that. Got another caller coming in. Let's see what the caller's talking about. Okay. Hello, caller. You want to help Hip Hop Radio?
Yes. Can I do a request, please?
Yes, you may.
Yes. I'd like to listen to 82 and 87.
Okay, 82, 87. Thank you so much for calling.
Uh-huh.
Would you like to give any shout-outs?
Thank you. Yes, let me give a shout-out to Headman and... That'll be it. Everybody in Houston, Texas.
All right. Keep tuning in, all right? All right.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. See, the callers mean everything to me, man. The callers are so important because they actually have the platform, you know what I'm saying, to be able, you know what I'm saying, to talk to the people out there. You know what I'm saying? I don't hold you guys like that. But I do want to say, man, if you know people that's in your family or any friends that's going through hardships and hard times like that, man, you got to show that support, man, and learn more. You know, like I do talk about Pap a lot, you know what I'm saying, because Papoose always keeps up on the criminal justice system. And if you haven't listened to his law library saga, go back and listen to all his law libraries. He actually talks about the statutory rape. He talks about firearms. He talks about terrorism. He's actually on Law Library Part 9 coming soon. So y'all will be hearing that soon from him. So, like I said, y'all, man, I really appreciate y'all tuning in. I got to rock out right now. You know what I'm saying? But I will be back on the air tomorrow. Make sure y'all catch me. I'm going to get up out of here, you know what I'm saying, with this record real quick. I'm going to pick a record. That's how I do. I just pick records. I just play a record and I rock out, man. Once again, man, thank you for listening. Help Hip Hop Radio. Let's go. JT for me, I see you.
About to get it. Man. Lavish. Nigga standing online, we don't never wait. You don't want beef, we don't hesitate. My nigga stay hungry like we never ate. Just smoked the blunt, about to levitate. Got my money up, about to levitate. Shorty got the cake, we can levitate. Shorty wanna drink, we can levitate. Let's get it. 3, 5, 7, make you levitate. Criminal mind when I ride. I be having thoughts of suicide.
Shut out, Headman.
Those don't fuck with you, and I know why. The cops don't have no U and ITY. Nigga, whole click wild and we all speak facts.
Ex-girl
texting, but I don't speak back. Yeah, the pussy good, but I don't need that. Call my dick 86, they come back for the crack. Yeah. Somebody hold me back. What are the realest? Yeah, somebody told me that.
I see y'all.
Crips, Bloods, yeah, we all repping flags. We gon' see her true color when the cat's out the bag. Scarface, Montana, call me Tony. You could try, but you ain't getting past my homies. Born thugs, mix it with a little harmony. Still catch you offset, no Cardi B. Niggas standing online, we don't never wait. You don't want beef, we don't hesitate. My niggas stay hungry.